Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the voltage regulator. And we will see that how the voltage regulator can be designed using the opamp. But first of all, let us understand why this voltage regulator is required. Now if we see the typical block diagram of any linear power supply, then it consists of the transformer, the rectifier, the filter and the regulator. So first of all, the input voltage is scaled down using the step down transformer, and then using this rectifier circuit, it is converted into the pulsating DC. And the variation in this pulsating DC is filtered out using the filter circuit. And if you see the output waveform of this filter circuit, then still it contains some finite amount of ripple. So the filtered output is then given to the regulator. And the job of this regulator is to remove these variations and provide the constant output. Now for any power supply, the two important parameters are the line regulation and the load regulation. And these two parameters defines how well the supply can provide the constant output voltage even if there is a change in the line voltage or the load. So the line regulation defines if there is any change in the line voltage, then how it will affect the output voltage. So this line regulation is defined as the change in the output voltage divided by the change in the input voltage. So for the ideal power supply, this line regulation should be equal to 0. That means even if there is any change in the line voltage, then it should not affect the output voltage. But actually, the output voltage does change with the variation in the line voltage. So for the good power supply, this line regulation should be as minimum as possible. Similarly, the second parameter is the load regulation, which defines if there is any change in the load, then how it will affect the output voltage. And it is defined as the no load voltage minus full load voltage divided by full load voltage. So here, this no load voltage is the voltage of the power supply when there is a no load connected. Or we can say that whenever the load current IL is equal to 0. And the full load voltage is the voltage of the power supply with the load when the load current IL is maximum. So for the ideal power supply, this load regulation should be 0. That means even if there is any change in the load, then it should not affect the output voltage. But actually, if there is any change in the load, then it will affect the output voltage. So for the good power supply, this load regulation should be as minimum as possible. So if the power supply is unregulated, or for the power supply without any regulator, the line and the load regulations are very poor. So to improve the line and the load regulation and to get the stable output voltage, this voltage regulator is necessary. So this voltage regulator consists of the following components. And based on the arrangement of these components, this voltage regulator can be defined in two categories, the series voltage regulator and the shunt voltage regulator. So in case of the series voltage regulator, the controlling element is in series with the load, while in case of the shunt regulator, it is in parallel with the load. So if we talk about the series voltage regulator, then the output voltage is sampled using this sampling circuit and it is compared with the reference voltage. And based on the error voltage, the control circuit takes the corrective action. So if the output voltage increases or decreases, then the control circuit tries to maintain the output voltage to the fixed voltage. Similarly, in case of the shunt regulator, the output voltage is sampled using this sampling circuit and it is compared with the reference voltage. And if there is any increase in the output voltage, then the control circuit shunts away the additional current such that the voltage drop across this series resistor RS will increase. And thereby it maintains the fixed output voltage. And it will get more clear to you when we will discuss the actual circuit. So there are many ways in which we can design this voltage regulator, but in this video we will see that how we can design this voltage regulators using the opamp. And first let us see the design of the shunt voltage regulator. So here this Vin is the unregulated input voltage and the output voltage is sampled using this voltage divider circuit. And as you can see, the sampled voltage is given to the inverting terminal of the opamp. Now here this Zener diode provides the fixed reference voltage and it is given to the non-inverting terminal of the opamp. Apart from that, here IL is the load current and IC is the collector current, or we can say that is the shunt current. So if we neglect the current through this voltage divider circuit, then we can say that the current through this series resistor RS is equal to IL plus IC. So now let us see the working of this regulator circuit. So let's say the output voltage has suddenly increased from its nominal value, and due to that, the sampled voltage by this voltage divider circuit will also increase. So let's say the voltage at this inverting terminal is equal to V minus, and the voltage at the non-inverting terminal is equal to V plus. So if there is an increase in the output voltage, then this voltage V minus will also increase. Now if you notice over here, the opamp is operated in the closed loop configuration, and in fact it is operating in the negative feedback configuration. So due to that, it will follow the concept of virtual short. That means it will try to maintain the same voltage at the inverting and the non-inverting terminal. That means even if there is an increase or decrease in the sampled or the feedback voltage, then also it will try to maintain the inverting terminal at the reference voltage. So in this case, if the output voltage increases, then the opamp will provide the more base current to this transistor. And due to the increase in this base current, the collector current of this transistor will also increase. So due to that, now the voltage drop across this series resistor RS will also increase. And due to the larger voltage drop, now it will compensate for the change in the output voltage. So due to the negative feedback, the circuit will try to maintain the output voltage at the fixed level. And similar type of correction will be applied whenever the load voltage tries to reduce. So in this way, this shunt regulator tries to maintain the output voltage to the fixed level. Now here, due to the negative feedback, we can say that this voltage V minus and V plus are equal. Or we can say that this voltage V minus is equal to V plus is equal to reference voltage. But if you notice over here, this voltage V minus can also be written as R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times V out. And from this we can say that the output voltage V out is equal to VZ times 1 plus R1 divided by R2. So in this circuit, by selecting the value of this VZ, R1 and R2, we can decide the regulated output voltage. Now one of the main advantage of this shunt regulator is its inbuilt short circuit protection. So in the worst case, even if we short the load terminals, then also no component in this shunt regulator will get damaged, and the maximum current which is flowing through the circuit will get restricted by this series resistor. But the efficiency of this shunt voltage regulator is very poor, and that is due to the large power loss across this series resistor and the shunt transistor. So typically the efficiency of this shunt voltage regulator is in the range of 20 to 30%. On the other end, this series voltage regulator provides the good efficiency, but unlike the shunt voltage regulator, they needs the separate short circuit protection. So now let's see how we can design this series voltage regulator using the opamp. So here the control circuit comprises of the opamp and the transistor, and the output voltage is sampled using this voltage divider circuit. So this sampled voltage is applied at the inverting terminal, and through this zener diode, the reference voltage is applied at the non-inverting terminal. So let's say the voltage at the non-inverting terminal is equal to V plus, and the voltage at the inverting terminal is equal to V minus. So here, if the output voltage tries to increase, then the feedback voltage V minus will also increase. But if you notice over here, the opamp is operating in the closed loop configuration, and in fact it is operating in the negative feedback, and due to that, the opamp will try to maintain the same voltage at the inverting and the non-inverting terminals. So here, if the load voltage tries to increase, then the output of the opamp will reduce. So here, let's say the output of the opamp is equal to VO dash, and the total output voltage or the load voltage is equal to V naught. So we can say that this voltage V naught is equal to VO dash minus VBE, where VBE is the voltage drop across the base emitter junction of the transistor. On the other end, if the output voltage tries to reduce, then the output of the opamp will increase, and in a way, it will try to maintain the fixed output voltage. Now, as I said earlier, due to this closed loop configuration, the voltage at the inverting and the non-inverting terminals are equal. So we can say that this voltage V plus is equal to V minus. And as you can see over here, the voltage V plus is equal to Vz. And at the same time, if you notice over here, this voltage V minus can also be represented as R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times V0. So from this we can say that this voltage V0 is equal to Vz times 1 plus R1 divided by R2. So by selecting the value of Vz, R1 and R2, we can decide the regulated output voltage. Alright, so now let me show you the simulation for this series voltage regulator. So as you can see in this circuit, the input voltage is equal to 20 volt, and here the value of R2, R3 and the reference voltage is set in a such a way that we should get the 9 volt at the output. So now let me just run the simulation and let me show you the output voltage. So as you can see over here, at the output we are getting 8.985 voltage, which is very near to the 9 volt. Now let me also show you what happens if I change the input voltage. So now let me set the input voltage to the 10 volt. So as you can see, as I change the input voltage to the 10 volt, then the output has been reduced from 8.98 to the 8.93 volt. So we can say that if there is any change in the input by 10 volt, then the change in the output voltage will be equal to 50 millivolt. Or we can say that for this regulator, the regulation is equal to 0.5%. And if you want to achieve the better regulation, then of course we can go for the linear ICs like the 78 series for the positive voltage and the 79 series for the negative voltage. So for example, the 7805 will provide the fixed output voltage of 5 volt, while the 7909 will provide the fixed output voltage of minus 9 volt. And if someone wants the variable regulated output, then one can even use the LM317. So we will talk more about this linear ICs in the separate video. But in this video, I hope you understood the basics of the regulation and how we can design the voltage regulator using the opamp. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.